going to discuss about the Plantae kingdom. Plantae, that is the plant kingdom, which is the fourth chapter of diversity in the living world, which is the first unit of intermediate first year botany. So now let us start with the plant kingdom characteristics. The kingdom Plantae now consists of all the eukaryotic and multicellular organisms. They are autotrophics, means they contain chlorophyll and they can also prepare their own food. So here in this chapter we are going to discuss about algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms and angiosperms under the kingdom Plantae. The algae, bryophytes and pteridophytes, these three are called as cryptogams or non-flowering plants, and the gymnosperms and angiosperms are called as phanerogams or flowering plants, or spermatophytes, means they can produce sperms. Non-flowering plants, they do not produce flowers, and flowering plants, they can produce the flowers. In this video we are going to discuss about the characteristics and classes of algae. Algae bear chlorophyll. They are simple thalloid structure and mostly they are aquatic organisms, and the size varies from unicellular, example is Chlamydomonas, and some are colonial, example is Volvox, and some are filamentous, example is Spirogyra. Next, coming to the cell wall, the cell wall is made up of cellulose. In addition to the cellulose, some algae contains pigments also, and the reserve food material is in the form of starch. This is about the characteristics of algae. And coming to the reproduction of algae, it takes place through vegetative, asexual and sexual types. So vegetative reproduction takes place through fragmentation, and the fragments gives rise to thallus, and thallus grows into new algae. And asexual reproduction takes place through spores. When these spores disperse, they give rise to new plant. Next, sexual reproduction takes place through fusion of two gametes. It is of different types. If the gametes are similar size and they fuse, it is called as isogamous, and two dissimilar gametes fuse, dissimilar size of the gametes fuse, it is called as anisogamous. And if one gamete is large non-motile female and another is small motile male gamete, it is called as oogamous type of reproduction. Example for this is Volvox. So let's see the economic importance of algae. Algae are mostly play a major role in carbon dioxide fixation on the earth by performing photosynthesis. Next, they increase the level of dissolved oxygen in their environment. The algae like Porphyra and Laminaria and Sargassum, they are used as food supplements. The brown algae and red algae, they produce algin and carrageen, which are used for commercial purposes. Agar obtained from Galidium, they are used in producing growing microbes, and they are also used in preparation of ice creams and jellies. The chlorella and spirulina, which are rich in proteins, they are used as food supplements by even space travelers also. So these are some of the examples of algae. Here the first row of algae are also called as green algae, and they are also called as Chlorophyceae. The examples are, this is Volvox, this is Chlamydomonas, and this is Chara. Next row of these three algae are called as brown algae. These are also called as Phaeophyceae, and here the examples are Laminaria, Fucus, Dictyota. Next, these two are the examples of red algae. These are also called as Rhodophyceae, and the examples are Porphyra and Polysiphonia. These are some of the examples of algae which are categorized under green algae, brown algae and red algae. These green algae are also called as Chlorophyceae, brown algae are also called as Phaeophyceae,
and red algae are also called as rhodophyceae. Let's see some of the characteristics of these three categories in detail now.
First, let's see the characteristics of chlorophyceae. Chlorophyceae are commonly called as green algae. They are unicellular, or they may be present in colonial forms, or they may be filamentous. They are usually green, grass green color due to the domination of the pigment chlorophyll A and B. And they store the food material in the form of oil droplets. They have rigid cell wall in which it has two layers. The inner layer is made up of cellulose and the outer layer is made up of pectose. These are the characteristics features of chlorophyceae. Next, let's see the characteristic features of rhodophyceae and pheophyceae in the form of differences. Here, this is the red algae and this is the brown algae, this is the rhodophyceae and this is the pheophyceae. So, the members of the red algae are generally marine and they prefer warmer areas. The brown algae members are always marine in their habitat. Next, the cell wall here shows polysaccharide called as agar, and the cell wall in brown algae, they have gelatinous coating and it is called as algin. Next, the red algae are mostly multicellular and these are simple branched or filamentous forms. Next, the red algae contains the pigments like chlorophyll A, phycomelins, the most dominant pigment which causes red color of the algae is called R pheoerythrin. This is very important big question. And here in brown algae, they contain pigments like chlorophyll A, chlorophyll C, and carotenoids and xanthophylls. And the major dominating pigment which causes the brown color is fucoxanthin. This is also very important. These store the food material in the form of floridian starch. These store the food material in the form of laminarin or mannitol. Next, the reproduction takes place here asexually by non-motile spores. And here, the asexual reproduction takes place through biflagellate zoospores. And the sexual reproduction takes place through oogamous, and here it is isogamous or anisogamous or oogamous. Here the gametes are non-motile. Here the gametes are pyriform or pear-shaped and they bear two flagella. Here the red algae, example for red algae is porphyra and example for brown algae is fucus. This is about the characteristics of red algae and brown algae.